and purple.
Hello everyone, it's your girl Jay, and today I'm here with my September wrap-up for 2019. I read a total of 10 books this month, so like always, we're splitting it up into two parts. This will be part one, which will feature the first 5 books I read this month. Part two will be out on Wednesday, which will be the last 5 books that I read this month. So without further ado, let us get started. The first book that I have, I wasn't originally going to put into my wrap-up, but your girl is behind on her Goodreads goal, so we're putting it in there. The book is called Big Turtle, and it's by David McLemons, and I actually had to read this for my language arts class in teacher's college, and we had to, like, critique it and how we would use it for a teaching moment in our class and, like, what grade level, blah, blah, blah. So, I mean, like, I'm not gonna go into big detail about it because nobody really cares. I gave it a 3 out of 5 stars. It is an Aboriginal folklore telling of the story of how the earth was created. I liked the bright colors. I had a good time with it, but like I'm never gonna read it again. It was literally just for that class. So I'm giving it the average 3 out of 5 stars, but we needed it to boost up that Goodreads goal. You know what I'm saying? The next book that I read was a graphic novel. It's called Bury the Lead, and it is by Gabby Dunn and Claire Rowe, and I ended up giving it a 3.5 out of 5 stars. It follows a 21-year-old named Madison Jackson, who is an intern at the Boston Lead, a newspaper agency, and she's trying to get her first headline story. She ends up getting this opportunity when a socialite named Delilah Kennedy ends up murdering her son and husband. Dahlia refuses to talk to anybody but Madison, and that's when she confesses to the crime and shoves Madison into the limelight. This was a very short and quick graphic novel. I did enjoy the colors. There was a lot of blues and purples, which really set like a dark and creepy atmosphere to the book. I really liked the representation in this graphic novel. There were a lot of LGBTQ+ characters as well as people of color, but it wasn't a huge focus of the graphic novel. It was just a fact that these were people and they were in this book. The biggest complaint I have for this graphic novel is that a lot of the plot felt very rushed. It almost felt that I had picked it up and it was actually the middle of a series and I was missing a lot of information, but I checked. It is the first in a series, so it was just a little underdeveloped for my liking. But overall, I did enjoy the story. I wanted to keep reading to figure out the conclusion of the mystery behind Dahlia and if she actually did commit the crime or not, so 3.5 out of 5. The next book that I have is The Last House Guest by Megan Miranda. I ended up giving this a 4 out of 5 stars. It follows a local named Avery Greer and her best friend Sadie Lohman, who is a vacationer to the island of Littleport in Maine. They have been inseparable for the past couple of summers in this little town. Then one day, Sadie is found dead and the police officers on the case deem her death a suicide, but Avery is not convinced. She's convinced that somebody hurt Sadie, and when fingers start to point towards Avery as the culprit, she decides that she's going to start her own investigation and figure out who actually murdered Sadie. I actually enjoyed this a lot more than I originally thought I was going to. I was going to give it a 3.5 out of 5 stars, but the ending definitely bumped it up for me. I really liked the alternating timelines of the past and the present, and I liked how it kept the mystery of Avery trying to piece together what happened at the night of the plus one party into what was happening in present day. I really liked how unreliable Avery was as a narrator at times, but I wasn't fully invested in her story either. I did want to keep reading just to figure out how she was involved in Sadie's death. It did start off pretty slowly, which is why I was originally going to give it a 3.5, but as more clues came to light, it did pick up. I also was not able to guess the ending, which is always a huge bonus for me in thrillers because most of the time I am able to guess the ending. So overall, a quick and fun read. 4 out of 5. The next book that I have, I absolutely adored. I give it a 5 out of 5 stars. It is Carval by Stephanie Garber. If you guys watched my reading vlog when I read this, it basically shattered my heart and I'm still not okay from it. I'm thinking of actually doing a full review of this, so I'm not gonna go into too much detail right now, but it follows these two sisters, Scarlett and Tella, who have always dreamed of going to Caraval. Caraval is a once in a year performance where the audience is actually invited to come and play in the game. With the help of a mysterious sailor, the two sisters set off to win a wish from Legend, the ringleader of Caraval, but upon arriving, Tella goes missing, and that's when it is discovered that the game is to find Tella before it's too late. So like I said, 5 out of 5 stars, full review to come, but this book ruined me and I'm so excited to pick up the second book. And then the final book that I will be talking about in this part one of my September wrap up is Water for Elephants. This is by Sarah Gruen. I ended up giving this a 4 out of 5 stars. So this follows a boy named Jacob Jankowski who, after the death of his parents, he finds himself very lost. His plans were originally to finish vet school and then join his father's business, but those obviously do not turn out. He ends up jumping onto a moving train and inadvertently running away with the circus where he becomes the circus veterinarian. While there, he befriends an elephant named Rosie and also falls in love with one of the performers named Marlena, who just so happens to be the wife of August, who is the cruel animal trainer. Then Jacob witnesses a very dark and deadly secret, and that's when he needs to balance his love for Marlena and wanting to belong in this crazy world of the performers. I honestly did not think that I was going to like this as much as I did. I was very skeptical going into it. I've heard that the movie is really good, but I don't know why I was just iffy about this book, but I ended up really enjoying it. I loved the alternating timelines that were presented in the book. There was Jacob when he was 23 years old at the circus, but then there was also Jacob when he was 93 and at a nursing home, and he was recalling all of the events that happened during the circus. My favorite character was definitely Rosie the elephant. She was just so cheeky and a lot of fun. I loved every scene that she was in. I also really liked Walter and his dog Queenie. I just thought they were really cute and a great addition to the story. I think that they were a really good comedic relief for the more serious moments, but they also did provide a lot of serious moments as well. You'd have to read the book to get what I was talking about, but it was a good balance. Don't know how I feel about Marlena. She fell a bit flat for me. I just honestly didn't care about her. August and Uncle Al, the head of the circus, were both just terrible people, and I think that they played the role very well. I really hated the way August treated the animals, so there's definitely some trigger warnings for animal abuse if you're interested in reading it and that's something that makes you uncomfortable. Be aware. I will say that I personally was really satisfied with the ending. I know that a lot of people have said that it's unsatisfying, but I really liked it. I think that it wrapped up the story very well. I'm definitely going to be checking out the movie now that I read this and enjoyed it a lot more than I thought I was going to, so let me know down below if you guys have watched the movie and what you thought of it, because I'm intrigued. Alright guys, so those were the first 5 books that I read in the month of September 2019. Let me know down below if you guys have read any of them, what you thought of them, and I'll see you all on Wednesday in part 2. Goodbye!